everyone, Christian here from CK Wraps. I'm going to show you how to install some Vivid Vinyl holographic chrome on the door of this Audi TT. Everything's been prepped. The surface area has been wiped down with isopropyl alcohol. Everything's been blown off with a compressor, so there's no dust contaminants or particles laying around. That way, when we remove the backing, we don't have any issues with it. The static pulling in the particles that happen to be floating around the car. So let's get started here. Not a complex area, the most complex part of this door being the door handle recess, I suppose. And then getting down near the bottom will be a little bit more challenging, but still not too difficult. Difficult areas lie in their fenders mostly on this vehicle. Got pre-cut panels over here already. So this one here has already been cut for the door. Bring it on over. Let's get it situated where we need it. All right. So, this vinyl in particular has a plastic cap on it to protect it, I guess from when you're squeegeeing or from shipping, for shipping purposes, I actually don't know. It can be installed with the capping on. I like to remove the capping, that way it lays down a lot easier. With the capping on, the vinyl's thicker, the capping also bunches when you stretch it, so it doesn't conform like the vinyl actually does. So we're going to remove the capping completely. As long as the surface area is clean, we shouldn't have to worry about any scratches, as well as having a fresh buffer on your squeegee, which is really important. The plastic capping is great, actually, so when you remove it, if there is any dust on that surface, it's gone. So it'll come right off with the plastic cap, and we're good to go. You can order this product through Vivid's website at vividvinyl.com. Also, as well as the magnets, squeegee, and 30-degree blade. You can get it all from Vivid. Great stuff to use. They have a lot of great products. These magnets cost half of what they cost from other manufacturers. So really strong, but not too strong. They don't leave impressions in the vinyl, which is another thing to be concerned about. So you want to make sure that your magnets aren't too strong, like the Avery, the Red Avery ones can be pretty strong. I'm going to grab some of this solution right here. This is Vivid Shield Guard, Scratch Guard, and UV protection. Just wet the buffer a little bit, helps the buffer glide along a lot easier, making the application a little bit more smooth. I'm also not ready with my heat gun yet, so let's grab that. Backing. I like to just kind of roll it off as smooth as possible. Keep the bottom elevated so that it stays smooth. We're going to reposition this once we get it down. Once we get it, the backing completely off, sorry. Step on this stuff, it's like glass. Sorry, not glass, ice. So just kind of put it off to the side. Don't want anyone hurting themselves. Fold it so it is more convenient as far as getting rid of. If you scrunch it up, it takes up a lot of space. down so it doesn't come off. I'm just gonna generally place this where we need it. Just kinda wanna let it drape. This is glassing, more or less. We're not gonna completely glass this piece because this is not a piece that you stretch. This is a more advanced install, so as far as when it comes to DIY, I'd stay away from this unless you had a lot of experience and knew what you were doing with vinyl to begin with. So let's get started here. So I'll take my Vivid Shield Guard spray, wet up the squeegee a bit. Material, so I don't recommend it. The thickness of it is quite a bit thicker than your standard films, your matte black, your gloss black, white, whatever. Make sure we're squeezing right to the edge, being thorough. Some heat is around the door handle area. What I want to do is we're going to bridge the door handle area, and you want this area to be, see how it's kind of crinkled right now? We want that to be kind of taut, pulled taut right over top of that. So I may not need heat. Okay, I don't need any heat, so that worked out really well. Couldn't remember if I did from the other side. Squeegee the rest of this. I'll do this last. We'll get down to it. Add a little bit more of the shield guard spray. You kind of feel it wearing off a bit. So let's elevate the vinyl. And that helps minimize any wrinkles that might come up while we're squeegeeing this area down. Probably have to add a little bit of heat as we get nearer to the bottom. I don't quite know yet. It's still going out. The wrinkles are still coming out pretty easily. And the shield guard spray just helps it so that the buffer doesn't stick to these wrinkles, and it really helps a lot when you use this spray. I mean, soap and water probably would do the job, but I mean, this is a product that Vivid has developed purposely for installing chrome for the most part, or gloss finishes, so it does a great job. Especially with the holographic chrome being so popular. floor is laid for the most part. We'll get into the recess of the door handle here. So this is a very delicate area. We want to stretch this little by little, and with heat from about 18 inches away, so we don't heat this too much and burn it. So this is where you need a wrap glove. Just working it little by little, keeping a little bit of warmth on it. Once we get this door handle down, it's going to require a pretty solid post heat. At the same time, when we're post heating chrome, we've got to be careful not to burn it. So, again, it's a very delicate process. Take your time. I do this a little bit quicker. Do is go over the wrap, make sure we're good as far as air goes. It's all about being thorough. Whatever you do, don't hold the heat gun too close. Keep it moving. But the air, or the hot air from the heat gun will show us if there are any bubbles in this vinyl or any air in the vinyl. By expanding the air that's underneath it. Air has moisture in it, and moisture expands when you heat it, so that's exactly what happens when we heat it. Get all our edges down. Finish this up right here. cover pretty much this entire area here and area here, but why not make it look as pretty as possible? Just shows for a good install. Let's post heat the surface area of the recessed door handle. Fantastic. So that's the hardest part of it all. I mean, the cutting is pretty straightforward. If you're installing this and you don't know how to cut, you probably shouldn't be installing this. So, not too much to explain about it. Don't cut the paint. Leave roughly a quarter of an inch, roughly, all the way around. Back of the blade always against the paint side. Make sure we're not cutting the paint. Even though someone might not see it, if you cut the paint, there's obviously opportunity for rust. So stuff to get salt, water, all that kind of stuff to get in there. So we don't want that happening. Make sure we have enough to tuck in under the seal. There is a dot here. I'm sure everyone noticed it. The mirror sits right here, so probably did a little bit of damage. From it sitting there, basically. Sitting there for a long time. Again, there's a seal here. I'm running the back of the blade on the edge of the seal so as to not cut the seal. You can use knifeless tape if you want to, whatever you feel comfortable with. The wrap cut tape that Vivid does sell does work for cutting this type of material, so I use it all the time. Perfect. finish this guy up, and we're almost there. So what I'm going to do is I like to heat the edges quite a bit. We don't want the material going anywhere, so it's just your post heat. And I honestly heat the heck out of the edges. Just makes for a longer, more durable finish. There's a seal here. Use your finger to initially start off the edge and then get in there with the squeegee afterwards, finish it off. Always lead with the heat gun. And as you can see, I'm keeping it moving. Let's tuck in the rest up here. We're sitting at 24 minutes right now for a chrome door install. I'm going to finish up this side right here with a nice post heat. Always, always, always post heat your edges. You want to kill the memory in the vinyl. You do not want it recessing. If it's going to fail, it's going to fail right along the edge. That's it. I'll cut out the rest of this right here. Grab the door handle, stick it back on, mirror as well, and then we're all done. So as far as door goes, pretty straightforward. Turned out really nice. You still see your reflection all the way through. It's consistent. There is a bit of a solution on it, but that kind of makes it look a little bit hazy. But other than that, it's done perfectly. So if you'd like to see any more videos, please feel free to subscribe and stay tuned to other ones that might be coming up. I've got a lot of chrome wraps, so anyone's interested in wrapping chrome, this is where to learn how to do it. CK Wraps, Christian, signing off. Enjoy.